For today's lesson, it's all going to be practice on the past 4 days of material and also the concepts from last year. So what I want you guys to do before we start all the practice would be just to do the do now, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Pause the video if you haven't, and play it once you are done. Looking at number one, it says, which statement best describes the solution to a two-variable equation? So, think about a two-variable equation. I'm going to write an example of one. Y equals 3x plus 1. Our two variables there are x and y. This is a straight line. We'll look something like that. So, what best describes the solutions to that equation? Looking at number one, it says the ordered pairs that must lie on the graphed equation. So every single, think about ordered pairs, x, y, that are on that equation of that line. And yeah, that's the answer. Or you can check that by saying, oh, is 2, 7 on the line? And you can plug in 2 in for x. Sorry, it's 2, 7 on the line. You can plug in 2 in for x and 7 in for y. So when you check that, the 7 would be the y, 2 would be the x. You get 7 equals 7, that, so that is on the line. They can't just be near, they have to actually be on the line. And ordered pairs that have x as 0 as one coordinate. There could be one solution with that, but it's not every single solution. And same thing with y equals 0, there could be a solution for that. But it doesn't have to be every single solution. Number two, completely simplify that cube root. What we're going to want to do here is, I'm first going to separate the cube root of 24 times the cube root of x to the 6th times the cube root of y to the 7th. So cube root of 24 times the cube root of x to the 6th times the cube root of y to the 7th. And now I'm going to break down each by the highest cube that goes into each of them. So looking at 24, the highest cube that divides 24 would be 8. So I'm going to separate that by the cube root of 8. And 24 divided by 8 is 3, so cube root of 3. X to the 6th is a perfect cube. So it stays x to the 6th. The highest perfect cube that divides y to the 7th would be y to the 6th, which leaves us a leftover y. So now I'm going to simplify each cube root that I can. Cube root of 8 would be 2. Cube root of 3 stays cube root 3. Cube root of x to the 6th would be x squared. Cube root of y to the 6th would be y squared. Cube root of y just stays cube root of y. And combine everything, so that'll be 2x squared y squared, and then combine the y and the 3 inside the cube root. And that is our answer. Looking at number three, we want to simplify that expression to see which one is equivalent to it. So what I'm going to do first is we have to simplify it. So we should be thinking of PEMDAS. So first thing, I'm going to deal with the parentheses. Can't add any like terms in the parentheses, so we go on to exponents. We do have an exponent here, so I'm going to rewrite x plus a squared as both of its factors. That'd be x plus a times x plus a plus 5 times x plus a. I'm writing out all the rest of that expression. So we dealt with the exponent. Now I'm going to deal with the multiplication. So I'm going to double distribute x plus a times x plus a. That would be x squared plus xa plus xa plus a squared. And now I'm going to multiply the 5 on the inside of x plus a. So it'll be 5x plus 5a plus 4. And now we want to combine like terms. The only two like terms we have here are the x plus a's. So what this simplifies to would be x squared plus 2xa plus a squared plus 5x plus 5a plus 4. So that is what our answer should look like. Let's look at choice 1. Well, our answer should have an x in it. Choice 1 has no x's. Look at choice two. It has X's, but it has no A's, and our answer has multiple A's in it. Let's look at choice three. All right, we can multiply that out and see if it works. But choice four, it's missing the two XA, so it has to be choice three. And you could check choice three by multiplying everything through, so we can do that. So we would do x times a, x times 4, and then a times a, a times 4, and also 1 times x, 1 times a, and 1 times 4. So you would get x squared plus xa plus 4x. Now multiply the a plus ax plus a squared plus 4a. Now multiply the 1 plus x plus a plus 4. I combine the like terms. XA and AX are like terms. Also the plus 4X and the plus 1X. And also the 4A and plus A. When you combine the like terms, you would get X squared plus 2XA plus A squared plus 5X plus 5A plus 4. And you see that's the same as we got before. So let's go to number four. For number four, I'm going to do the same thing I did for number three, and I'm going to separate the a to the 1, the x to the 8th, and the y to the 6th. So that'll be the 4th root of 81 times the 4th root of x to the 8th times the 4th root of y to the 6th. And now I'm going to write them as the highest perfect to the fourth power that we can separate each of them by. So 81 is actually 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, so that's good. I'm going to write that as 3. X to the 8th, fourth rooted, would be x squared. But y to the 6th, fourth rooted, we can simplify that further. That would be the fourth root of y to the 4th times the fourth root of y squared is what is left over. So we're left now with 3x squared. The fourth root of y to the fourth is y. And the fourth root of y squared, well, you can think of that as, if you rewrite that as a rational exponent, y to the 2 over 4. And 2 over 4 is really 1 over 2. So I'm going to write that as 1 over 2. Now combine our y's. So we definitely have a 3x squared. I can cancel out, well, I can cancel out everything but 1. But how do we get that y to the 3 over 2? Well, you add the exponents here when you're multiplying with the same base. So 1 plus 1 half would be 3 halves, or 3 over 2. And for number five, the first thing I want to do is try and simplify any terms in the numerator and the denominator. So when I look at the numerator, 3 can't do anything with that, but that radical 12, I know I can simplify radical 12 a little bit. So radical 12, the highest perfect square that goes into 12 is 4, so it'll be radical 4 radical 3, which is 2 radical 3. All right, so I'm going to rewrite the top as 3 minus 2 radical 3. Now I'll look at the denominator. I can simplify. Well, radical 3 is going to stay, but 1 over 9 to the negative 3 over 2. Let's use our laws of exponents. If it's a negative exponent, we flip the base, so it's not going to be 1 over 9 anymore. It's going to be 9 over 1, or 9 to the 3 over 2. 2's in the denominator, so that's the index on the radical. So that would be the square root of 9 to the third power. Square root of 9 is 3. So this would be 3 to the third power, which is 27. So the bottom would now be 27 minus radical 3. So we simplified each term as much as possible in the numerator and denominator. Now I'm dividing by a value that has a radical in order to rationalize that denominator. We need to multiply by the conjugate of the denominator, the conjugate. Remember, you just change the sign of the operation. So instead of 27 minus radical 3, it'd be 27 plus radical 3. And you have to do that on the top and the bottom. So when you multiply that out, we're going to multiply everything in the numerator. The 3 by 27 and 3 times radical 3. So 3 times by 27 is 81. 3 times radical 3 plus 3 radical 3. Then the 2 radical 3, negative 2 radical 3 times 27 would be minus 54 rad 3. And negative 2 radical 3 times radical 3, minus 2 times 3. Over, we have to now distribute the denominators. So that would be 27 times 27, which is 729. 27 times radical 3 plus 27 radical 3. Negative radical 3 times 27 minus 27 radical 3. And then radical 3 times radical negative radical 3 would be minus 3. Let's combine like terms in that numerator and combine like terms in the denominator. So that's going to equal 81. I get the 81, the radical 3s would become minus 51 radical 3. 2 times 3 is minus 6. All over. 729 minus 3 would be 726. And the 27 rad 3 and minus 27 rad 3 cancel out. We have to do one more thing in that numerator. Let's combine the final set of like terms. 81 minus 6 would be 75 minus 51 rad 3 over 726. And that could be our answer, but let's see. Do we have anything we can factor out? And yes, everything, every term in the numerator and denominator has a common factor of 3. So when I divide everything by 3, that 75 becomes a 25, 51 becomes a 17, and 726 becomes 242. So our completely simplified answer would be 25 minus 17 rad 3 over 242. So that's it for the do now. The rest of this, whatever you don't get done in class, is homework. I will post the answer key to this also. Good luck.